Hey, what's up?
We're Neon Dreams. Dreams, and you're watching Stingray PausePlay.
I'm Zach Monson. Welcome back to a very special edition of Stingray PausePlay here with Canada's very own Neon Dreams. Hi, Jess.
Hey,
what's up?
How y'all doing?
Great.
Amazing.
We had some fun conversation seconds ago that I wish we could bring into the interview, but we will talk about your bathroom habits a little bit later. So why don't you guys tell me the first memory that you guys have of meeting each other?
Yeah, I met Frank first. We went to a school called J.L. Ilsley in...
Not jail.
Yeah, it sounds like jail. That's why I had to pronounce my words.
Yeah.
But... Yeah, we both like really didn't go to class much, and we always met up in the music room because the music teacher would just let us hang out there regardless of the day. So he just kept asking me to join his band, and after a while, I was like, I don't know, I just felt this thing inside me that if I ever wanted to do anything in music, it would be with him. Yeah. That's like true, and that was our first interaction, really.
You guys snuck me off YouTube.
Yeah. And I had this one buddy who, like, we spent a lot of time on this Halifax music forum online, and he knew him through that and through going to shows. He was like, there's this young kid that, you know, puts drum covers up online. His name's Adrian. Like, you should hit him up. And he had his number. And, like, literally, we found him off YouTube just...
The number's not that hard to get, but I'll give it
not
away.
Not now.
I'll give it away.
It's in the description of the YouTube video.
And right next to it says desperate.
It flashes on the screen the entire time. Please call me. Somebody please call me. Tired of playing drums alone.
Any friends?
You know, you guys graduated from the Alan Slade Juno Masterclass. You guys, the one band chosen to kind of perform at the Junos, which is incredible, really. What is your favorite experience and your favorite moment from that whole time that you spent doing the Masterclass, doing the Junos, going red carpets, all that kind of stuff?
I think it was actually just playing the Junos because we all grew up watching our favorite bands play, right? Like we were saying, like Billy Talent, Sum 41. Yeah. And it's just like a Canadian... Junos are iconic, right? So
to be able to be on stage and play, it was the most insane opportunity.
That end of it kind of just like wrapped the whole masterclass into one, you know what I mean? It was like everything we learned, everything we took from the program just like came together on stage that night. So
we asked the last artist in to ask you guys a question. The artist was Sophie Tucker. My question for you is...
Hey, this is Sophie.
And this is Tucker.
And we're Sophie Tucker.
So would you rather... go on a date with me and bathe elephants together?
Or would you rather go on a date with me and dance all night?
I like bathing elephants.
Yeah, bathing elephants.
I would love to bathe an elephant.
You do elephants. Currently like bathing elephants. Is this something you've done before?
I haven't done it yet, but I just know I'm going to enjoy
it. I've done it.
You've done it.
Yeah.
I feel like you're lying to me right now.
If anyone has done it, it's Matt.
Have you actually bathed elephants?
No.
See, I mean, I didn't think so. You're a liar. You shouldn't be on the show. That's really all I'm saying. Yeah, leave anytime you want. Your current single is Find a Way. Talk me through the song, what it's about, who it's about, how it came together.
So Find a Way is a song that we made with our producer, Corey, out in a song camp we attended, which is Gordy Sampson's songwriting camp.
That's a great camp.
Yeah, he's
Port City is out of that
Port
camp
City,
too.
Yeah. And that song is
actually,
just
that's a co-write with one of the guys in Port City.
Really?
Yeah.
Dylan?
Yeah.
Love those guys.
Yeah. We hung out with them. Yeah.
So it was a simple song about love between everybody that was involved with it.
And then
about the love of the people writing the song.
Everyone has their own perspective.
Love triangle.
Right? Yeah.
I heard that you weren't a singer. And that the only reason you're a singer is because you like lost a bet or like pulled the small straw.
Who told you that?
Is that true?
Pretty much like before all these guys, there's a little band I had, and it's called, I'm not even gonna say the name, but
oh, you gotta say the name now.
I didn't even know this.
It was called Four Words.
Was
it called?
Was it a four?
No,
and then
four
word?
And then word.
Wow. Yeah. You should have told me. you should have kept that to yourself.
Anyways, we were all like, we all came to a jam space and we were like, all right, who's going to sing? And like nobody wanted to do it. They said, well, draw a straw. And then I got the shortest one. And for some reason, I stuck to it.
And did you,
I was
did
bad
you feel
for
like
seven
you sucked
years.
Right away? Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I was bad for 7 years.
So what was the point that you kind of sang and you're like, I'm terrible, to the point where you're saying, you're like, I'm not the worst singer I've ever heard? What changed? Just practice?
I guess we just kept doing it for years, and is around marching bands when we made that song. My voice kind of like shaped into this new sound.
You thought you sucked up until marching bands. It's like that song didn't come out that long ago. Yeah,
we've been playing together for 9 or 10 years now, so that's a long time.
Yeah, okay, all right. To
I'm
suck.
Myself,
it's a long time
I'm
to suck. Yeah. All right. So last time that we spoke, you guys were telling me about your new project, working with Trevor Guthrie, working with 303. What else can you tell me? When's it coming out? What is this, an album? Is it an EP? Is there other collaborators? Anything you want to share, I'd love to know.
Ooh. You can tell them the title.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. The Wolf Princess and Me.
The Wolf Princess
and Me.
And Me.
Yeah.
Who is the Wolf Princess, and what is the Wolf Princess?
So it's like three entities. The Wolf, they got... And the princess, so the princess.
Okay, so it's the wolf, prince, comma,
yeah, princess.
Princess, and me. Not the wolf princess.
No.
Okay. That's I say get rid of the comma.
Wolf princess sounds like
the
some
wolf
Zelda
princess
stuff.
And me is good.
Yeah. The girl you're trying to get, but she's with a wolf.
Ah, okay. Yeah. Okay.
And he's the knight in shining armor.
And he is.
You're me. Like what? Like a bush? Like what? I don't get it. Okay, so song wise, what can you tell me song wise? Collaborators. Guest features.
Actually, no features on this one.
On
yeah.
But yeah, there's the collab with Trevor Guthrie on it. We kind of I think we dug more into our rock roots on this one.
Yeah, okay.
So we're like Find a Way and Merchant Bands almost has like the reggae kind of vibe.
Yeah.
We kind of went back into our rock roots and it's cool because it's like a mixture of like electronic and rock.
Yeah.
And I don't feel like it hasn't been done a lot. So we're really excited to put it up.
So when can people expect it?
I'd say like. Fall, early fall.
Yeah. Okay, all right. I'll be patient. That's I heard that all three of you have really weird food habits.
Really?
I'm telling you this.
What's happening?
Adrian, I know you love like seafood, and you have a tendency of like opening really stinky cans and slow and like confined spaces.
I asked you before this if anybody told you anything, and you said no.
No
one did.
This is just something that I happen to know about you guys. And I mean... Frank, I hear you'll put any food with any food between two pieces of bread. Is that true?
It's so true.
Why? What's your favorite mystery combination that you've come up with?
I just take whatever like I have for leftovers and put it on.
It's great. Yeah. I had a spaghetti sandwich once.
It's delicious, right?
Like, it's like sandwich,
right?
Well, you put bread on the side. Why
carbs
not put
on
it
carbs.
In
yeah, why not? Exactly. If you're gonna
like
have a piece of bread with butter,
right?
it's like remixing a song.
Like, you take a bunch of different songs, you put them together, and
so you just start a diner called the Mashup.
Wow.
See, 10% right here. Matt, I hear you're on a countrywide search for the world's best veggie burger.
Why do you even know this?
But not being a vegetarian yourself. So how?
Who told you that?
So where does that come from, and why are you on this search? Why not just a regular burger?
I don't know. I have no clue. I had one veggie burger that was really good, and ever since I've been chasing that dream. It's like heroin.
Okay, wow. So your sandwich is like mashups. Your veggie burgers are like heroin, and you just like stinky fish cans.
Absolutely.
I like you guys. I really, really appreciate you guys coming to chat with me. You going to play some music for us?
Yes.
Absolutely.
I can't wait. You can hear Neon Dreams on Stingray Music's Hit List channel, Canadian Indie channel, Total Hits America, and of course, all over Stingray Music's Vibes channels. Don't forget to leave us a comment, drop us a subscribe, keep up with us. See you next time, guys.